The last time you picked up a phone to call your business partner about work or to call your friend, you might have been using fiber optics. Last time you logged into the internet from your home computer, you may have been using fiber optics. We hear a lot about fiber optics these days, but what are fiber optics? You know, in simple terms, a fiber optic cable has a center that's made of very thin glass. And light can travel through the glass and relay light signals, and those light signals reproduce sound and other information. Fiber optic cables stretch thousands of miles all across the world, and they send information quickly and very, very efficiently. But there are some problems with these cables. First, since they're glass, they can be brittle, which means they can crack and they can break. And digging up the cables and replacing the broken ones, lots of times very expensive. And second, in order to produce the cables, factories must use very high heat, which is also expensive. Fiber optics are amazing, but they could use some improvement. Amazingly, scientists have found an animal that has a wonderful fiber optic cable. The sponge, called the Venus flower basket, lives in the deep waters of the ocean. And this sponge produces several optic cables that grow out of its base. And these tiny cables are about as wide as a single human hair, and they grow to be anywhere from about 2 to 7 inches long. And the fibers produced by the Venus flower basket, they've got several advantages over the man-made fiber optic cables. First, they're produced in cool temperatures. You know, if we humans could learn to copy this, well, we could save millions of dollars. Second, the fibers from the sponge are very strong and they're very flexible. And they don't break like the ones that humans make. In fact, the fibers from the sponge are so flexible they can be tied into knots. You know, if scientists could learn to make such strong, flexible fibers, we wouldn't have to spend as much time and money repairing the ones that we have now that break because they're brittle. This remarkable sponge was featured in an article in USA Today, in which one of the researchers commented that nature often provides us a better way of doing things. You know, it's a self-evident truth that where there is design, there must of necessity be a designer. Where there's a painting, there must be a painter. And those who work in the field of biomimicry, the field in which they study nature and they try to mimic or copy the things that they see there, to invent helpful technology. They freely acknowledge design in nature. For example, what seems to be one of the most popular websites on biomimicry offers a course titled Biologist at the Table. In the course summary, the site describes the participants as those who are biologists and naturalists with a passion for the natural world and an interest in applying nature's elegant design strategies to human challenges. It simply does not make much sense to think that over a period of billions of years, evolutionary chance processes developed elegant design strategies, the likes of which even our most educated, brilliant minds have yet to understand. Intelligent scientists have been working on fiber optic cables for many years just to get them to work as well as they do now. Yet the Venus flower basket has strong, flexible fibers that are produced in cool temperatures. If there is design more intricate and efficient than is produced by highly intelligent humans, the designer of that design must have an intellect equal to or greater than the humans themselves. The writer of Hebrews accurately noted, "For every house is built by someone, but he who built all things is God." God's design in the sponge's fiber optic cables proves that animals like the Venus flower basket, they didn't evolve. Design demands a designer.